I'd like to tell you a story about a woman who had the rarest condition, one so critical that even one idle day would cause her body to malfunction. So out of sheer determination to live, she ran. At dawn, she would whisper encouragement to herself. She would serenade strength to her bones to keep moving. But one day, she stumbled, violently. But she didn't lay there. A whisper climbing its way out of the rubble of defeat strengthened her body. A melody from within encouraged her arms to swing and sway past the pain as she limped and took a step and then another, hobbling forward with a face soaked in tenacity until it became clear that a fall was just one step away from a rise. I'll let you in on a secret. This is a part of our story. And she is the church of the living God, the body of Christ. We have one of the rarest conditions. It's a heart brimming with the charge to love beyond our means. We have been chosen not to be stagnant, but to run a race not given to the swift. So we run with undying resilience and endure because our source never runs out. Every part of this body reflects a people, and this part is named Haiti. A devastating earthquake has left it battered and bruised, tens of thousands of homes destroyed and countless families displaced. This is our wound. When our joints sprain, we ache. When our body is cut, we bleed. Everybody can't do what this body was made to. So God ensured that everything we need is everything we have. If His Spirit is whispering encouragement to us, His wind is serenading strength to these bones, then who and what are we waiting for? Our children are sitting on the shoulders of this courage. Their youthful eyes are matches lit by this hope. Nations have been rebuilt by the bare-handed faith of these prayers. Haiti will not be an exception. We are His body. Please believe there's a reason why some of the strongest joints are at our knees, but our knees enable praying and standing. The ground may have quaked, but we are not shaken. Let us take this step as one and stride forward with our spines laced with the resilience of the martyrs of old who would lay down their lives before they put out their light. And the Spirit that raised our Savior from the dead has made His home in us. This is our fight. Let us rise together. Let's rise together so our unity may be living proof that indeed the church is marching forward.